between all the children of Adam. Not only is the saying of the Prophet ﷺ, but the action of those who are in Hajj. When you go to Hajj, you look around you and you see people who all look the same. No rich, no poor, no white, no black, no ethnic this or ethnic that. Everybody is a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A true show of what this deen stands for. And when our Prophet ﷺ, in the day when the faith is completed, declares in no unambiguous terms that all the children of Adam are created equal. That equality stems from a divine guidance, from the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for those who want to fight the waves of intolerance or racism, nothing would empower you more than the divine faith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you to become a champion of pluralism, intolerance, and the fight against injustice and racism. In it, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sanctified life and the human life and emphasized the sanctity of human life, and he said that people are to protect others and not to attack others. A whole universal principle of peace and a message to the whole world. In it, the Prophet ﷺ declared that riba is haram, and he made injunctions for people to follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about social justice and about the need to take care of one's family, the need to take care of our sisters, and the need to take care of the family component. Values and principles that go far and beyond the confines of Mecca, and they apply to all of humanity. You see, when Ibrahim alayhi salam was called upon to call people to come to Hajj, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيرٍ. Ibrahim alayhi salam, it is reported that he said, "Oh Allah, I am in an arid land, there is no people around me, there is no life around me. How can I call people to it?" Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, "Oh Ibrahim, you make the call and we will make it happen," subhanahu wa ta'ala. And only years after his offspring, his grandson, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would come to make Hajj in Mecca with over 100,000 of his companions. The same Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who left Mecca being kicked out of his own town and his own city, and he would say, "By Allah, I would have not have left you if its people did not push you out." Yet he comes sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replying the call. And today millions and millions of people are answering the call. The call of who? The call of Ibrahim alayhi salam, the believer. Inna Ibrahim kana umma. Ibrahim, the characters of Ibrahim, what are the characters of Ibrahim? The patience, the perseverance, and his family alayhi salam. Who are the people who started this tradition and revived this tradition, if you may? Hajar alayhi salam and her son Ismail alayhi salam. Hajar, a young woman who goes with Ibrahim alayhi salam to take her to a desert. There is no water, there is no life around her. Yet he would leave her and he would walk away. And she says, "Hajar," she says, "Is this the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" And Ibrahim alayhi salam would tell her, "Yes, this is the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Then she would say, "Idhan lan yudayyana." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never leave us alone. And sure, she didn't sit and just cry her lot. She kept on running, she kept figuring out what can she do. And today millions honor the tradition that Hajar alayhi salam did when her walking between or running between the mountains of Safa and Marwa. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought his mercy and brought the water under the feet of Ismail alayhi salam. Ismail alayhi salam, the son of Ibrahim, the son of Hajar, the man who lived with his dad so that they can see the seedlings of monotheism in that land. Ismail, when he was a young boy, Ibrahim would come to him alayhi salam and he would say, "Oh son, I see and I have been ordered to slaughter you." Ismail alayhi salam, very young man, what does he say? He has been raised properly. He has been taught how to remain steadfast on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. "Ya abati fa'al ma tu'mar, satajiduni insha'Allah min as-sabirin." Oh my father, do that which you have been ordered. You will find me, inshallah, amongst the patient ones. So not only are the lessons of Hajj important to us, but it is the characteristics of those, that we celebrate their traditions today, their dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their perseverance, their sincerity, their hard work, indeed ought to inspire us as we remember this beautiful occasion of Hajj. And as we remember this completeness of faith, the faith of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, embodied in the life of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and brought to us generations after generations, so that we can enjoy it, and so that we can stand for it. وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا لتكونوا شهداء على الناس ويكون الرسول عليكم شهيدا. It doesn't go just as an honor. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. That it is a responsibility, it is a requirement to give and to do, and that's for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we celebrate Hajj, my dear brothers and sisters, remember the traditions of Hajj. Remember the whole purpose of sacrificing one's effort and time so that you can seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and nothing else. Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you learn the lessons of Hajj, you honor the universal principles that were sent to all of humanity. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent you but mercy to mankind. This divine guidance is not just for us. This divine guidance is for all of humanity. These principles that we espouse and we live by and we stand for are ones for others. It may be law, or it may be ethics, or it may be philosophical principles. For us, they are divine guidance from the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, the source of all guidance. So for us, it's a matter of principle, it's a matter of belief, it's a matter of life and death. We will stand with those principles, and we will sacrifice to no end for those principles. And then we look at the characteristics of those who brought us the tradition of Hajj, and we realize that those are our forefathers. Those are the ones that inspire us to be who we are. So we need to emulate them, and we need to live by their characteristics and high morals so that we can be successful both in this life, inshallah, and in the hereafter. And then lastly, we need to realize that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as is Ibrahim alayhi salam, they went and they found nothing else around. Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he took Hajar and Ismail, it was empty land. Yet they made something out of it. And they created a society that brought the lives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our Prophet. When he was there, he didn't take no for an answer. He didn't give up. Even when he was kicked out from the most beloved land that he was part of, he would come back only years later with hundreds of thousands saying, لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك. So he صلى الله عليه وسلم and the people, they have made something out of their own self. You see, we have all that tradition, we have all that treasure, but what have we done with it? What have we done to apply it in our own society, our own environment, our own people? You see, the same way our brothers and sisters are attesting to la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, being witnesses that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Mecca, so should we, and so have we, to be witnesses for truth and justice in our own surrounding. That comes in so many ways, and that comes in so many responsibilities. We cannot shy away from the fact that